I'm Denis Fonseca, and I will present this paper that also is related with other papers in the next track, in the next part of time, that are related to the same project that we are developing to the, in contribution with the Polytechnic of Catalonia to the Ministry of Spain. The main idea of the project is to change the way to use the technology and some type of 3D elements in the architecture and urban education, because these type of students are very classical. They are very used to use the printer plans, the physical mockups, and we are seeking to introduce the 3D concepts using augmented and virtual reality, gamification, and the main idea for us is it's necessary to assess these type of technologies, these type of methods, using, for example, the feedback of the final users, the citizens, and using also the feedback of the students. Our project is focused, in this case, in the city of Barcelona. The main idea of the government is to change the use of the typical streets for more pedestrian uses. Then it's necessary to obtain the feedback of the citizens for assess if the uses that the mayor city are proposing are okay for them. And for the students, it's very important that all the type of projects that they can develop are in concordance with the main idea of the final users. In this case, for example, we have developed using Unreal Engine glasses for virtual reality, some type of modeling the street that where we have a focus or project. Then all the elements that you can see here, for example, in day or in night, are you can change, you can move, you can interact, you can add new elements. And for us, it's very complex to use this element and also the systems to move the elements. And for this reason, we have use an qualitative assessment. This qualitative assessment is based on an bipolar labeling assessment. Why this type? Because if you select an qualitative assessment, you are thinking about some type of questions. But using a bipolar labeling assessment that has three steps is more easy to understand the comprehension of the usability of the elements that think about the users. The bipolar labeling assessment is focused in three steps. The first one is the designation of the elements, positive and negative. The second step is, okay, marking these positive and negative elements. And finally, the answer must include a specific explanation to improve. For example, you have put an a 7 and a positive element, why not a 8? Why not a 9? Please, can you tell me about what do you change to improve this opinion, or in the case of negative, it's more easy. What is the improvement that you can apply to give a more positive answer? We have focused in this paper three tasks to evaluate. In this case, when a user needs to put elements in the environment, insert and remove elements in the scenario, place elements in the environment. It's necessary to check the move, the rotate, and place elements using the system proposed. And finally, to evaluate the render of the space, the quality of the elements that you can see in the space. For example, this is an example that you can see in the paper. Positive elements are grouped, for example, in these positive common elements that are seated for more than one person, and the positive particular elements, maybe because only one person has seen this situation. It's the same in the negative. If you have a very cited incremental index for an element with a positive answer, this maybe is a very interesting thing that you don't need to change. But if you have some questions with a low assessment and high citation index, then you need to change, you need to improve. How to improve? The same users, the same students, I'm telling about what are the main ideas to develop and to improve. It's not for me, it's for them, the final users, that you can see here the common improvement elements with the mentioned index about the ideas for maybe different type of problems. Conclusions about this study using that bipolar laddering. For example, our system has a high realism. This is a good immersive experience, help to understand the space. On the other hand, in the first steps, it's a complex system to understand all the possibilities that you have in your hands. It's necessary to improve the lighting, especially when you are working in a night scenario. It's necessary to put the specific type of light that you have in the city. For example, it was one of the conclusions that the citizens had said to us, and we translate this information to the students to put in the mind of the students that when you need to develop a system, you need to think the final user, not only in the presentation of the project. It's very important to take into account the user profile, as we can see in the next presentation in a few minutes. The results, if you are talking with a student or with an architecture expert, is very different to a non-expert user.